Hey everyone, welcome back to another writing video. My name's Alyssa and this is my channel, Shimashe Writes. Today I'm going to be doing a short little video talking about how I am so confused with the short story that I finished earlier today before I did dishes. I ended up printing out the story and having my mom read it. She doesn't know what to do with it, or what I could do with it, and to her... Okay, I'm just going to show you, that is the title of it. If you can, it looks backwards to me on the screen, but hopefully you can see it. And I have three characters. I have the devil, I have Allison Gretchen, which I might change to Gretchen Allison because I liked Gretchen for this particular character, but I wasn't sure if Gretchen was a name that can be used as a first name. So I asked my fiance and he's like, it sounds like it can be both. So I'm going to actually switch the names. And then I have character two. So I literally put character one, character two, and then lead character. And once I realized, okay, this is the devil and this is Allison Gretchen, I did do a kind of news article on the Simple Malfunctions page on my blog, which I'll leave down below. It's just a short little thing because it's a short little story. This is how it's formed, or like the format. And yes, I'm showing you this even though it will be changed shortly because I need to do something with this. I like the idea. I have my mom read it. The only thing I spelled wrong was trophy, which I was writing this. I literally was brushing my teeth and two of the paragraphs, or three, the first three paragraphs came to mind. And I was trying to remember it as I was finishing brushing my teeth. And then I came up here, opened up a new document on my laptop, and just started typing. And I'm like, I have no idea what I'm typing, but I like it. But now I'm confused. I am very, very confused with this story. It is set in Braidson, and because Allison is from Braidson, which is the fictional town that I came up with, that is set in California, which most of the fictional towns that I come up with are going to be set in California, just because that's where I live, that's what I know. Unless I'm saying it in Seattle, which I have been there, and I do have family that does live there, so if I have questions, I can ask them. But I do not know. I mainly only wrote dialogue for this story, and my mom said that it sounds like Persephone and Hades. And it's also partly inspired by a Disney short. I'll show you. I have my tablet and it's still somewhat charged. I have 26% left. I need to charge this. Okay, Disney Plus. I'm trying not to make this video too long. I just wanted to do a writing video talking about my recent short story. I did also write another short story in the form of a letter for this collection. I don't know if this collection is going to make any sense by the end of it. I hope it does. But, so I watched The Goddess of Spring the other night in the middle of my binging Sweet Life of Zack and Cody. Trying to find it. Well, rewatching Sweet Life. Because it's been years. Okay, we're short. No, it was in classics. Wasn't it? Because I went to Disney. And this is on Vintage Classics. There we go. If they still have it. I'm just going to show you the kind of thumbnail photo. So that is what I watched the previous night, or a couple nights ago. Also, around midnight, all ideas come to me, or almost all ideas come to me, right before I'm getting ready to go to sleep. It's really annoying. Do you have that problem too? Anyways, this one, the Goddess of Spring, is a vintage classic, and it's about this goddess who is the Goddess of Spring, and she's like the queen, and all of the animals that surround her and are really happy around her, and it's just like a happy springtime feel, which I like because I was born in spring. But then the devil comes and takes her down to the underworld and tries to give her like crowns and jewels, and it's just kind of, it's a singing one as well, and I think that's also where this idea came from. But it's kind of like my own twist on it, and I think I kind of want to expand this story. I don't know. Like, I think I'm going to expand the story a little bit, and I might change up the format from this with the characters and then the dialogue. And it's a different way that I've written something, and I'm also wondering, maybe I should be writing this in a poem format, but at the same time, I don't know how I could do that. Because it came to me like a song, because the Goddess of Spring was a song, but then I may have had influence from Hades and Persephone. And my mom asked me if I knew the full story, which I am going to be doing research on that. But I've never been this confused over a short story that I've written so far. And I think I even have short stories that I haven't even released or shared anywhere. Or I may have shared them on my blog, but this one is so confusing. Because it's written in a way that I haven't written a short story before. And I'm thinking maybe this is a poem. But it's not going in that poem collection that I'm working on, because it kind of relates to what Braids in Town is. I don't know. I do not know. If you guys have any tips, let me know down below, because I am so confused and I don't even know what to call this video. But this is a writing video because I'm talking about writing, or at least my short story. Also, you can expect in the next couple of weeks some unboxing videos, because I have a new pen collection, sort of, and one pencil and new pencil case. So I'm excited about those, and I'm trying to look forward to those so that I'm not stressing out about this story, because I've got no flipping idea what to do with it. And right before I started this video, I was like, okay, I'm gonna start editing this story or rewriting this story. I'm keeping the title because I like the title. This is probably the only other title that you will get from this collection. But while we're here, I need to look for it. It's right here. I moved some stuff around so I could clean up. So in this notebook, I'm also like going to be using it for like random ideas. And if I have a short story that I want to write and that I don't want to type and be looking at my laptop, that's where this maybe comes in. And this feels a lot better, or like this brand of composition notebook feels a lot better than the ones from like the Dollar Tree or from Walmart. So I'm just gonna call this one the letter for right now because I don't have an actual title, but that's the first page and that's how long it is without showing you. I need to expand this one as well and kind of figure out a way that I can make all of the first three stories make sense. Because now the collection just seems really weird. It could work, but I have to figure, like, I know I want the concept to be life and death and finding that hope when you're in the midst of darkness like we have been in the world as a whole this year. And I like using life and death as metaphors as well in my stories and in my poems. So I know that bit of it. I just need to figure out like what the rest of the stories, and I might be doing that now after I upload this because I don't have anything else to do and I'm starting to get bored and I'm like, I need to figure out something to do or go ride my bike and be active a little bit. I don't know, I'm just very confused today. But I did get to talk to my best friend, Melissa. Technically, she's like my sister. So I did get to talk to my sister, and that was amazing. I can hear the phone ringing downstairs. Besides that, I don't know. Actually, what I might do is I might take this with me along with this and this. Actually, no. You know what? I'm going to get this, my traveler's notebook, because you guys know I switched into this one. I was almost tempted yesterday to switch into the one that I'm calling In Me, my brown one. And I'm almost, like, in the future, whenever, like, Emma and I have our own house and we can actually afford to adopt a dog, I kind of want to name the dog In Me as, you know, like, the joke. That's all that's going through my head because this week is pretty much Indiana Jones week because I watched the first and second one at the beginning of the week and now I want to watch the rest of them. So I'm going to take this, going to be taking this and this. I'm going to staple it. Actually no, I might go to CVS and get a binder so that I can have a binder for my short stories, which I've been meaning to also get a binder, and I can't believe that's something I didn't think of getting. I'm gonna go on a bike ride to a Wildwood Park. The smoke has cleared, thankfully, for the most part. It's still kind of smoky outside, but it's gotten a whole lot better, thank you to the firefighters and everyone working hard to get those cleared. I haven't journaled every day, but just to show you where I'm at, I have about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 pages written on. So I can do a little bit of journaling. And this is my 0.5 pencil. So I might just, I want to bring this one because I like having this one as a companion to this. But since it doesn't have an eraser, I'm bringing the red one. The blue one is in my chic sparrow. I'm gonna go on bike ride. I hope you guys have a lovely day and that you're having much better time with your stories, and that you're not confused with them, because I am confused with this one. It's only 2 pages because it's only the dialogue and I didn't do any other writing than putting the character and the dialogue down. And I really feel like this is meant to be a poem, and maybe getting outside in nature would help me. I'll try and take some pictures for Instagram, and I'll leave my Instagram down below at the end of this video. Or I'll leave it down below in the description box of this video. I hope you guys have a lovely day. Thank you so much for watching. That's just kind of my rant for the day. And I'm filming this on Wednesday, but it's going up on Friday. Yeah. I really just don't know if I should expand that whatever in, or if I should turn it into a poem, because I did make it kind of rhymey as well. Who knows? We will see. I will see you guys in the next video, which hopefully will be an unboxing, because I do have a Twisby Eco coming, and I will not be able to use it because I won't have the ink yet. For some reason, the Twisby is being sent before anything else that I got or ordered over the weekend. But I'm so excited still. So, I hope you guys have a lovely day and happy writing. Bye, everyone.